Hi everyone, welcome to Java Techie. So in this tutorial we are going to discuss how to develop a SOAP-based web services using Spring Boot framework. So basically there is two ways to develop SOAP-based web services: contract first approach and contract last approach. So in contract first approach, first we need to write our WSDL file, then from WSDL file we need to generate our Java binding classes. In contract last approach, first we need to write our Java implementation, then from implementation we are going to generate the WSDL file at runtime. So in this example we are going to use contract first approach, where we are going to write the WSDL file first, then we will generate our Java classes. But as we are using Spring Boot framework, we no need to write the WSDL file, only we need to write the XML schema definition, which is called XSD file. Okay, so Spring Boot will take care to generate the WSDL for us if we are using the contract first approach. So let's discuss one use case which we are going to develop today. So we are going to develop an API who will able to evaluate loan eligibility for a customer, where customer need to give the input as name, age, income, CIBIL score and employment mode, and it will return the response as is eligible for loan or not, approved amount for loan and mismatch criteria. So these are the input, which input is not matched to get the loan, that will be comes under mismatch criteria. Okay, so this is what the implementation, this is what the API we are going to expose using SOAP based web services. So public acknowledgement, evaluate loan eligibility, then the customer request as a method argument, then we need to write our business implementation. Okay, so let's get started guys. Let me open my Eclipse. So let's create a Spring Boot project, new Spring Starter project. Give the name here, Spring Boot SOAP web services. So change the package here, com.javatechie.spring-soap.api. Click on next. So let's add the required dependency. So we are going to add web services dependency. So you can observe Spring have the implementation for Spring web services. So we are going to add DevTools to auto restart. So let me add that. Now let's finish it. So application imported successfully. Now let's go to pom.xml. There is some error as we are using 2.1.5 version. This is what the latest version of Spring Boot, but I believe there will be some bug. So let's change it to 2.1.4. And we added Spring Boot Starter web services dependency and dev tools for auto restart, right? So one more dependency we need to add here. Let me add that WSDL 4j to work with Spring Boot SOAP based web services. Okay, so let's do one Maven build. So there is no error, we are good now. So as we are using contract first approach, first we need to write the WSDL file, right? But as we are using Spring Boot here, we need to write only XSD file. XSD file will contain the structure of your input request and response. So if you observe here in PPT, so the input request are customer name, which will be one variable, age, income, CIBIL score and employment mode. Similarly, response is eligible for loan, approved amount and mismatch criteria. So let's add those field in XSD. Go to Eclipse. So in SRC main resource, create a file called XML schema definition. So other, search as XML schema. So click on next, name your XSD file. I am giving loan eligibility dot XSD. Okay, so go to the source. Let me format it. So we need to add our own XSD with the input request and response. So let me add that. So if you observe in XSD, I added one target namespace, which is similar to package in Java. So I am giving http://www.javatechie.com spring soap api and loan eligibility. and I am giving one short name for that target namespace. And if you observe, this is what my customer request, which is my input class, and having those are the input field, which we can say customer request is one my class, and these are the variable of that. Okay, customer name, age, yearly income, civil score, and employment mode. Similarly, this is what acknowledgement is my response. So in acknowledgement, I have three field: is eligible, which is type boolean, and approved amount for loan, which is long, and criteria mismatch, which is the list of string. That's why I added here marks occurs unbounded. Okay. So we can say this XSD is your completely skeleton of your input request and response. So writing XSD will be more easy if you understand what to do in your input request and response. Okay. So we created XSD file for it. Now we need to generate our binding classes from this XSD. So to generate binding classes from XSD, we need to add one plugin, that is XJC plugin. Okay. So let's add that in our pom.xml to generate binding classes. Go to build section. Yeah. So here we need to add the XJC plugin. So this is what the XJC goal, which is one plugin to generate the binding classes by read this XSD file. Okay. So if you observe, I give your schema directory, SRC main resource, where we have the loan eligibility.xsd and output directory, which is inside SRC main Java. Okay. So based on your target namespace, let me show you that. Based on your target namespace, this XJC tool will help to create the package to generate those binding classes. So let's run a Maven goal. There is some error. Yeah, let's do once again Maven update. Yeah, so there is no error now. Let's run Maven, any goal you can run. So I'm running Maven install. Let me zoom the console. There is some error. No compiler is provided. Yeah. So let's change the build path. So it's pointing to JRE. We need to add it to JDK. Edit. We need to point it to JDK. Similarly, let's change the compiler version to Java 8. It is there. So apply and close. Now let's rerun our Maven goal. Maven install. Let me zoom the console. Yeah, build is success now. So let's refresh our application. So if you observe here, one more package created by this XJC tool, which is com.javatechie-spring-soap-api.loan-eligibility. This is what we mentioned in our XSD file with target namespace, isn't it? Yeah. So if you go this, it created one class called customer request, which is this one. Customer request one class, and with those are the field. So let me open that. So this is what my class, and those are the field: name, age, yearly income, civil score, and employment mode. Similarly, it created acknowledgement, which is our response, with three field: is eligible, and approved amount, and criteria mismatch. As we specify in our XSD, if you observe in acknowledgement, we specify marks occurrence is unbounded, right? That's why it considered as a list of string. And few more class it created, object factory, which will help to instantiate all your generated binding classes for customer request and acknowledgement. It behave like a factory method, and if you go to package.info, it contains your structure of your target namespace, which is similar to package in our Java. Okay, so let me close all. Now we need to provide our own implementation So let's provide the implementation of it. So let's create a package called service dot service here. Similarly, let's create another package which is our endpoint, which we are actually going to expose that one. So API dot endpoint, and let's create another package to provide our own configuration. Okay. Dot config. So in config we need to provide where it will be generated the WSDL file and what will be my port type name and which servlet context it will load. All those information we are going to write in our config file. So let's first provide the implementation of it. Create a class called something loan eligibility service. Okay. So let's annotate this class with @service. And let's write a method something like public who will return acknowledgement. So method name check eligibility, check loan eligibility. It will take argument as customer request, which is our Pojo class generated by XJC tool. Import it. So if you observe, this import statement is coming from our target namespace, which we specified in our XSD file, and that's what the package also created, right? Yeah. So let's provide implementation for it. So let's create the object of acknowledgement. Now get the mismatch criteria from our acknowledgement response so that we can map what are the field mismatch to apply the loan. Okay. Control shift O. Okay. Mismatch criteria list. Now we need to get that list from our response acknowledgement dot get criteria mismatch. Okay. Control shift O. Yeah. Let me zoom it. So here we will add condition for each field, for age, for CIBIL score, and for employment mode. Like this, we need to add. Okay. So let's add if request dot age greater than 30 and so we need to add the and operator here. And request dot get age less than equal to 60. Okay. Then this person is eligible to apply loan. Okay. But we are going to add the criteria mismatch here, right? If it is not matched, then that person is not eligible to apply loan, right? So that's why we added not condition. So let's add the message to mismatch criteria list dot add. Okay. So you need to write the message here. Person age should be should in between 30 to 60. Okay. Similarly, we need to add condition for other field. Let me copy this if statement. So another field, what are the field we have in customer request? Let's provide for yearly income. So I want to give if that person yearly income is more than 2 lakh, then that person is eligible to apply loan. Okay. Request dot get yearly income greater than 2 lakh. Okay. Then that person is eligible to apply loan. So here if criteria is not matched, so you need to provide the some criteria mismatch message here. So something like we can specify minimum income should be more than 2 lakh. Okay. So similarly add another condition for our CIBIL score. So let me open it. So we applied for age, yearly income, and let's add for CIBIL score. Okay. So if CIBIL score, sorry, let me add it in our service. So if CIBIL score is greater than 500, then only that guy is eligible to apply loan. If it is less than 500, then low CIBIL score, please try after 6 months. Okay, so we added condition for 3 field. Now let's build our response. So what we can do here, we need to check the size of this list. If it is greater than 0, means criteria is not matched. Any of these 3 is failed, right? So that person is not eligible to apply loan. Like this we can add here. So if mismatch criteria list dot size greater than 0, then that person is not eligible to apply loan. So set the response acknowledgement dot set approved amount 0, and similarly acknowledgement dot set eligible false. Okay, and similarly let's add the else. If criteria is matched, then that guy is eligible to apply loan. So what we can do, we need to add acknowledgement approved amount. So requested amount, request dot get. So we don't have any field to map the amount here, so give some random value. I'm giving 5 lakh. Okay, and is eligible true, and we need to return this criteria list by set with the acknowledgement. So what we can do, if that person is eligible, let's clear that list dot clear. Okay, now let's finally return our acknowledgement object, return statement. Yeah, so we are done with our implementation. Now we need to write our endpoint, which we are going to expose, right? So we created one endpoint class, create a class loan eligibility endpoint, or else loan eligibility indicator endpoint. Okay, so we need to annotate. So annotate here endpoint. Yeah, so if you observe here the import statement, Spring Framework web service server endpoint annotation. Okay, so now let's specify our namespace URI, which is our target namespace. So private static final string, give like namespace and copy the URL. So the URL will be in our XSD. Let's copy it. So let me add it here. Now let's inject our service where we provided our implementation. Let me zoom it. Private loan eligibility service, service inject using auto add. Okay, now we need to write our endpoint here. So write something like public acknowledgement get loan status or something like that, and we need to pass the input request here, which is our customer request. Okay, now we need to call the service dot check loan eligibility, give the input. Okay, so as this is my request, we need to annotate here request payload, and this is what my response payload, and we need to specify the payload route as well, payload route where we need to give our namespace which we just created. Okay, and the local part will be same as per your input request. So let me show you which is your root element. This is what the local part we need to specify. Okay, so let's add it. So we are done with our development. Now we need to provide the configuration of it. So as we are using Spring Boot, we are not going to write the WSDL file. We are only writing the XSD file, right? So we need to inform to Spring Boot to generate USDL file for us. So for that we need to provide few configuration. So let's create a configuration file. Basically we are going to do Java-based configuration file. So let's create a class called soap ws config. Okay, annotate this class with @configuration, and we need to enable the web services. Okay, so first provide the configuration for servlet registration bin. So create a bin called servlet registration bin, and provide the message dispatcher servlet. So create a method something like, give the same name, initialize message dispatcher servlet. So give this name, make it lowercase. Okay, so let me zoom it again. So let's create a object of this message dispatcher servlet. Servlet equal to new message dispatcher servlet, and we need to set the application context here. So let's write the application context here, which is coming from Spring framework. Okay, and in servlet now we need to initialize our application context. Servlet dot set application context, give the context. Okay, now let's add servlet dot set transform usdl, make it true. Now let's simply return the new servlet registration bin. Okay, and here we need to provide the type generic, pass the argument as servlet. Okay, and we need to provide the URL mapping here. So let's give something like /ws/*. Okay, so annotate this with @bin. So now we need to provide the configuration to generate our USDL. So we need to specify the port type and what is my URI, those things we need to configure here. So let's create a bin public something like default USDL. Let me type, USDL 11 definition. Okay, so give the same, not this one, give the same name. So make it lowercase. Okay, so here we need to provide the XSD schema. And we need to create the object of this default usdl definition. Default usdl definition, new default usdl, this one. So now set the port type and all those stuff here. Dot set port type. Port type name. So let me give this indicator one. Any name you can give, but we need to follow the naming convention here. So I am adding this, remove this endpoint. Okay, now we need to set the URL so that client can consume it with that URL. Okay, set something location. So here we need to provide /ws, same URL you need to provide, which we map to with your servlet. Okay, now we need to provide the target namespace, which we specify in our XSD. So definition dot set target namespace we need to provide. So let me copy this. Okay, not this. So let's add it. Now we need to provide the schema, means this XHD file location you need to provide, right? So let me create a schema. So create another bin who will create a schema for us. So public XHD schema and return new simple XHD. Here you need to provide the location of your XHD. So our XHD will be in resource, right? So we can provide new class path resource, then give the path, the XHD name. Let me copy that name. Okay, so let's add it here. So we need to give this to this default usual definition. Okay, so add this with @bin. So add the schema here, default usual one definition dot set schema. We need to provide the schema. This will be injected here. Okay, so let's return this. Now we need to annotate this with @bin, and we need to provide the name of the bin here, because with same name you can see your runtime usdl, which will be generated by Spring Boot itself. Okay, so let's give some name, loan eligibility. Okay, so you can give any name with which you want to see your usdl. Yeah, so I believe we are done. Let me cross verify once. We provided service, we annotated @service, and we created endpoint. Okay, and we created config for servlet bin and usdl definition, where we set the port type, URI and target namespace, and set schema. Those are the field we need to write if you are writing your usdl manually. So as we are following the Java based configuration, Spring Boot provides support for this configuration. Okay, and this is what the XHD schema, which we loaded from our SRC main resource. Okay, so we are good now. Let's run our application. Let's go to Spring Boot application. Let's run it. Run a Java application. Yeah, so you can see here our application is up on port 8080. So let's go to browser, hit the URL to verify your runtime usdl. So localhost, it's running on port 8080, and we have the URL ws/ the bin name with which you want to generate the usdl file. Yeah, this is what the usdl it generated, right? So this is what our request with all the field which we mention in our XHD file, and rest other part, message and port type, binding and services, will be generated by Spring Boot itself. That's what the beauty of Spring Boot if you are working with so best web services. Now let's test our API. Copy this usdl, go to your SOAP UI. Okay, you can click on SOAP and give the project name Java Techie SOAP test, and give the usdl URL here. Now click on OK. Yeah, if you observe, it generated our API, so we can test it now. So click on this request. So let me zoom it. So let's zoom it. It's not working, the zoom one. So yeah, let me increase the size. Yeah, now we can give the input request. So let's give the customer name to user 1 and give the age. Let's first test with the valid case. Give the age something 55, which will becomes under 30 to 60, and let's give the income 4 lakh. Okay, and let's give the civil score something like 700, and employment mode something government. Okay, now hit the API. You are able to see this person is eligible for loan. That's why it's true. And the approved amount 5 lakh, which we set the default one, and there is no mismatch criteria list, as this is the valid details for to apply the loan. Okay, so let's do something. Let's change the age here to 25, and let's change the income to 1 lakh, and civil score will be let it be. So let's try. We should get two criteria which is not matched. Okay, so let me hit the URL. Yeah, so if you observe here, we are getting is eligible false, as there is two criteria which is not matched. Person age should be in between 30 to 60, and the minimum income should be more than 2 lakh. Okay, so if you change CIBIL score here something like 200, you can find one more mismatch criteria. Let me hit the URL. Yeah, low CIBIL score, please try after 6 months. This is what the endpoint we exposed as a SOAP based web services. Okay, yeah, so this is how you can expose your SOAP based web services by using Spring Boot framework. So if you will use Apache CXF or some other implementation, you need to write the WSDL completely by your own. Then we need to generate the binding classes, and you need to provide the endpoint for it. So Spring Boot make our work easier than other implementation. Yeah, so that's it about this particular video, guys. If anyone have any doubt or concern, you can add a comment. And those who not subscribed yet, please go ahead and subscribe it. Don't forget to press the bell icon, guys, so that you won't miss any update from Java Techie. And thanks for watching this video.